Meet Greyson Chance. You might remember that incredible voice from his viral Lady Gaga cover at just 12 years old. Primary school Pavarotti to Ellen DeGeneres star.
The last classroom I had been in was really bright when you called. Took me out of school.
I took him out of school.
Grayson's pushed through the pitfalls of child stardom.
Now that I'm 25 and I'm older, I can recognize that what happened to me as a kid was not cool, it was not okay. And I've had to wrestle with so much of that PTSD.
Now three albums deep with a buzzing career, Grayson's launched his latest record, Palladium.
And Greyson Chance joins us now.
Thank you so much for having me.
No, thank you for speaking to us. Congratulations on this album. It's a really personal album. But also, I think importantly, your first that's not with a major label. Was that freeing for you?
Yeah, very much so. You know, I am 25 years old now. I was signed first when I was 12. So it honestly feels like such a dream come true to still be making music. People still come to my shows, thank goodness. This was just the result of fully trusting my creative instinct, and this was what came out. So it could have been a result of maybe being boxed in for a long time in my career, but I didn't think too much on this record. I just sort of let things happen in the way that they did.
Greyson, sometimes I trust my creative instincts and I get fired. does it ever go wrong trusting your creative instincts so much?
I definitely have probably a few songs in my catalog in my career and a few of my early videos that I would love to erase off of the internet. So maybe we're in the same boat there.
You're a really interesting person because of everything you've been through. And you speak, I think, quite movingly about feeling that you had PTSD, like you experienced real trauma as a result of being a child star. It makes me wonder, do you think that children just should not be famous?
I mean, it's a tough question. I don't think that's, you know, possible, right, in our world of entertainment and things that happen. I think I am fortunate for my, position where I have been able to come out of it in the way I have. I see, you know, other stories around me and you know, this week when I did hear about Aaron Carter's passing, I went on stage that night and it affected me emotionally because I realized how fortunate I was to be able to be at the position I am now. I think it's just more an important reminder that we need to be careful when we need to recognize that when kids are in the industry, they are still, at the beginning of the day, kids. That's the most important thing.
Greyson, in a recent Rolling Stone article, you spoke about your time being signed to Ellen DeGeneres' record label, and by your account, you weren't treated very well there and you were dropped pretty soon after. What was it like for young you to go back to normal life after that?
The first classroom I went back into after being plucked away from school at like 12 years old was when I decided to sort of quit music and I went to college. For 2 years and back in Oklahoma where I was from. But when I got dropped by the label, it was more or less of a very quick, sort of effort to try to pick up my career or whatever pieces I had left of it.
That's a difficult industry to navigate when you're an adult. But when you're a teenager, how does that feel? Because who would you even know how to rely on people?
It was very hard and very difficult. And, you know, the story I think that you're referring to was that Rolling Stone article. And, that was a story and a part of my life and, you know, my career that I've been wanting to tell that story now for, to be honest, probably 5 or 6 years. And I don't think really ever had the courage to tell that story. I think there were a lot of people that, you know, encouraged me not to do it. But it was something that felt really necessary for me moving into this next chapter of my life because, at 15 years old, trying to figure out how to keep a career alive and having a lot of people relying on that, that's insanely difficult and it's a lot of pressure to put a kid under.
Greyson, let's talk about touring. Is there any chance we're going to see you out here in Australia soon?
You know, out of the 12 years that I've been doing this, I've never been to Australia.
Come on!
And it looks like, that is finally going to be changing.
Yay!
At the moment, it's looking like I'll be coming out in hopefully spring of 2023.
Oh, that's awesome.
And I'm very excited. I'll be staying at Rachel's house. She offered it to me. So,
you will be, and I will be taking very good care of you, Greyson. I'm an excellent house host.
She will have a newborn baby, so you might have to get up and do some nighttime feeds.
I only invited you because I do have a child and I don't want to pay for somebody to come and help me with that, so you are going to be doing that. I hope that's fine.
Okay, never mind. It was great to talk to you.
Well, Corbis just cancelled a whole tour. In the meantime, Grayson's new album, Palladium, is out now. Grayson, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.